located in the Netherlands, and you can find me on Ravelry as A.M. Memelink. You can find me on Instagram as Kleurendraad, and you can find me on Facebook on Kleurendraad, but I have a link then all below. Thank you for watching me. Thanks for sharing your time with me today. I have a new episode. This is my second episode. And today, what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell you about my WIPs, my works in progress. I have 4 here. I have 7 in the back. Not bothering you with those ones. That will come. And what else? I wrote it down. I'm going to tell you about mohair. What are the possibilities to use mohair? I made some samples. I will show you what the blend will do to your project, and so that will come. I will have a little song for you, and it suits the mohair, but I will tell you about that later. And then I will show you some objects that I have here, which I've knitted with mohair, so you can see what it does in the project, and I have a few finished objects. So thanks for being here. I said that already. I live in Holland. I live on a farm, and there's nobody around, and so we love it here. And we live in a small village, Bewit, and well, it's small. It's like 200 people living there, and it's such a nice village. People leave you, people want you, and it's all good. So, yeah, and every year we have a dorps festival, a village festival. And that's really nice because there is, in the center of the village is a big tent. And there's a big party for four days long. But unfortunately, this year it's postponed to next year because of Corona. Well, finished objects. I just start in because I have a full program. The first one is the one that I'm wearing, and it's Eucalyptus by Junko Okamoto. And Junko Okamoto is known by her very specific designs. First of all, the line of the sweater. I will stand up later. But then with all the details she puts in, it's amazing. I made the Papa sweater, it's on my Instagram account, and it's with all wildflowers. And this time I made the eucalyptus. I'll stand up for you. And it's all, they look like Japanese flowers actually. And you see the design, it's just white and, well, because I've knitted it with DK, the back is the same. I've knitted it in DK, and it's always a double thread because you alternate to get the stripes, and it's quite thick, but not too thick that you get the flames out of your body because you're hot. And it's nice, and that's because also I think of the springy DK that I use, that I have in my shop. And yeah, I love it. And this one I had already. And I use it when I drive my car, so my hair doesn't go everywhere. And, well, Mark said, why don't you put that on as well? So it looks like it's deep winter now, but it's not. It's raining outside, but it will get better this week. I use it as a jacket. So I don't have any summery jackets, so I always put on a sweater. Well, the green color you see here is Elo in my shop. And the white color, it's not white, it's very light lime, is lemonade. I will link that all below. And when you dye with colors, sometimes the colors look different on a different base. And I have a good example here. Well, this is Elo, and it's a tonal. Well, if you're sitting on a galloping horse, it's a tonal. But if you look very close, you see there's always some spots that I covered less. And that's so fun. That makes this sweater go lively. You can see it. Sometimes it looks darker. Sometimes whiter. And that's what I always give a tip to people that buy sweater quantities. I always say alternate skeins. That's the tip that goes for almost every hand-dyed yarn, because the dye will always find its own way when you hand-dye it. And if you alternate skeins, then you can't see the difference. And in my next video, I will give you a tutorial for that, but on YouTube you can find it as well. But this is a baby Suri alpaca, also with the same amount of dye in yellow color, and then you see the difference. And that's why you can use them together, because the alpaca stands out because of its fiber, but it also stands out because of its color. And I love this color. So that's my first finished object. The second one I posted already on Instagram is the Bird Song by Maschenwunder. And I used two colors. I used Pearl Harbor and Confetti. And if you look close, you see that the birds, they look like they have all different colors. That's the yarn actually that does it. And it was quite a count, I must tell you that. Quite a count. But what I did is I used the outside of the birds and looked at the pattern so I could make the shape. And well, it didn't go that well. One bird actually looked like a lizard, and I just embroidered it the right way. The back is the same. Yeah, a really nice and quick pattern actually, because I always say that, but this is counting, this was Netflix. And this is also a tonal, but if you alternate skeins, you see that it doesn't bother. If you use one skein and then another, it could be that you have two different sizes. So, how do you call that? You have two different sizes. No, you see the color difference. So, yeah, Birdsong in 4-ply. Actually, it was a customer that ordered the colors for this one, and she, she came up with those two colors, and I thought, well, why don't I do it myself? And I did it. So those were the finished objects too. Mohair. No, I'm not doing the mohair. I'm doing the works in progresses now. So I have four, like I said. And the first one is, let me see, SFT by Shay Johnson. You see, this is DK and this is mohair. And you can make the sleeves longer if you want, but it's really nice because it's like a décolleté from mohair. So it goes like this in a point. This will be mohair, bit of a sleeve, and then the DK goes further. And what I used for this is my color Camouflage in the shop. It's a new color because I love camouflage trousers. I have a lot of them. And I thought, why don't you dye a color like that? And well, it's not a top down, it's a bottom up sweater. And here you can see it. And you see sometimes spots where the light meets the light, and yeah, I love it. And for the top version, I have lac and mohair. So this will be my SFT. That rhymes, actually. Yeah. I think you need 3 DKs, but I'm not sure. You could probably make it with 2. Not sure what the pattern calls for, but I will find that out soon. And this is lac and mohair. So if you want a specific color in mohair, you can always order lac and make a note above. Like if you see another 4-ply color that you like and you want to have it in mohair, use lac for that. Okay, the second finished object. No, Astrid, the second whip is another Junko Okamoto design. And I love this one. And it's the bouquet sweater. And if you look closely, you see threads just coming in front of your work. And I'm not sure if she came up with this technique, but it's so nice because you just lay your thread in front, you knit the background, you put it back and you knit further. And so sometimes you see, standing up again, a bit of ferrule, and then you see the threads coming. And I love this pink on the sticky toffee. And I have a picture, but it's not very bright. She didn't use colors so different, but it's the bouquet sweater. And there's lots of nice examples on our Ravelry page. And again, this is with a low sleeve, and yeah, it's knitted with DK. And these are the colors that I used. Sticky Toffee and I. Those two. So that's the bouquet sweater. That was the SFT. Then I have, and you can see that I love pink, another cumulus blouse. And this time it's in mohair eye color. Look, I made this one already, and it's like a light fluorish green, and it's such a light sweater. You can even wear it when it's hot outside, when you go to the beach and you want to cover yourself. So nice. And the edges are round. And oh, so nice. And I thought, well, I need another one. So, and that's this one. Steffi ordered this color for the cumulus. And yeah, and I thought, I want that too. So, well, when you have your own web shop, you get very greedy and you want everything. That's probably why I have so many whips. But look at this color. Isn't it everything? Yeah. So, I did the top, I did the yoke, I separated the sleeves, and from now on, Netflix. As if I'm looking at Netflix every day. I'm not. But I'm calling it like that. So see, this is the cumulus blouse by Petite Knit. And she actually wears it on the beach. So it's knitted in two threads of mohair together. And you need four skeins for a medium large size. And the last whip that I'm showing you is this So Faded. And I know it's an old pattern, well, old, it's a couple of years old. It's from Andrea Mowry. And yeah, but I think it's timeless, this sweater. You can wear it always and everywhere. And I used, well, this is what I have so far. And she had a very nice bit on the shoulder, actually. It's just garter, and then it goes in tricot all the way down. And you see that I have already two colors. I had a very small amount of the second color, also pink. And the colors that I used were Cherry O' Baby from my shop. It's a bit brown with some purple spots, green, pink. The second color that I used is Unicorn. So you see them next together. And then I have Try Little Tenderness, and that's dyed in like a very light gray color with old speckles. And this is my latest new one, Blame It on the Boogie. And those two together, you see a slight difference, and that will be very nice when the sweater is finished and you see all those colors together. So that was So Faded from Andrea Mowry. Excuse me. Well, that's that for now. Those were my whips. Well, what I'm going to do now, I'm going to show you some examples that I've knitted with mohair. And, well, I think I'm going to sing every episode with a matching song. Sorry if you don't like that, but I love it. And this song is actually, I'm going to put it ready. This song is actually a Bob Marley song. And why does it suit the mohair? Because, well, what I'm going to talk about later on is the melting of the mohair with your merinos. And melting, stirring, stir it up. Stir it up, Bob Marley. And I love Bob Marley. I remember when I was 15, I went to a concert together with my sister and her friend. And it was, I think, a year before he died, actually. And we were sitting there in the arena in Rotterdam. And there were all concrete shelves where we were sitting on. And by that time, you could smoke inside. Well, I was not smoking weed and marijuana, but all the others around me, I guess, everybody was doing that. They were wearing their Rasta hats. And the smell when we came in that arena. And then I sat on that concrete and only the Wailers stepped forward. The three ladies, they were always singing with him. And everybody started to tap their feet. And the concrete shelves, they were really bouncing. And I was sitting there, 14, 15 years old. And I thought, my God, what's happening? And that concert was amazing. I will never forget it. And so years and years later, when I was in Oman, when I was singing there in a band, one of the first songs I sang with them was Stir It Up. And well, because I'm going to melt that in the mohair story later on, I will sing that for you. I'm not sure how long it will take, just until I'm ready, I guess. Yeah. So we have to wait for things to start. There it comes. Don't you love that reggae beat? I love it. Oh, reminds me of all the days. I love it. Bob Marley was a legend, is a legend. Even my children love it. My daddy loved him. Loved it. And he, yeah. Stir it up, little darling, stir it up. Did you hear the Wailers? Stir it up. Ooh, little darling, stir it up. It's been a long, long time since I've got you on my mind. And now we are here, I said it's so clear to see what we could do, baby, just me and you. Come on and stir it up, little darling, stir it up. Come on and stir it up. Ooh, little darling, stir it up. A little bit more. Thanks. I'll push the wood, yeah. Blaze your fire. Then I satisfy your heart's desire. Said I stir it up, yeah. Every minute. All you got to do, baby, is keeping up for me and stir it up. Last bit. Little darling, stir it up. Come on and stir it up. Ooh, little darling, stir it up. Now's the intro. Oh, I'm not gonna sing anymore, but in Oman, Aziz, he was the conga player. I can still see him always smiling. And he was actually playing in the Sultan's band as well. Really nice. I loved that band. And the name of the band was Still Thinking About It. So that was very confusing for people that asked our name. And he said, so what's the band name? And then we said, Still Thinking About It. Oh, so when will you come up with a name then? We were still thinking about it. But that was the name of the band. Good memories. That was in 2000. Oh. 20 years ago. It was 20 years ago. Okay. Mohair. Stir up mohair in your projects. Well, there is a few misconceptions about that. Well, you have kid silk mohair, you have baby suri alpaca, and you can blend it in your projects and they will be so soft and light and they will give that extra to your project. But for example, I have here a little sample from this color. Let the curtain fall. If you mangle that, if you stir it up with mohair, what happens then with the original color? Well, I made another sample. And I keep them together so you can see. On top, you see an overall brown piece of mohair merino. It's nothing less than this Let the Curtain Fall and Teddy Soft mohair. Then you see that if you mix those two colors, the original color is fading out. You can still see the dots. You can still see the dots, but not as much as you see it in the sample. Goes as well with the second piece there. I stirred it up with green. And the last bit, I stirred it up with pink. So you see that if you choose this color, and you just want to make another fabric, but you want this color to be the star player of your project, then don't mangle it with a colored mohair, because it will fade out. If you like that, if you say, okay, I like the undertone here, I see green speckles, I want them back, but I love brown, just mangle it together and you get the top piece. Now, what would you do if you want this color, but you want it exactly the same, but in mohair as well? Then just use the same color mohair, the same dye bath. You can always ask that, I told you. Just order laken and put in the top, I want laken to be as Let the Curtain Fall. And I will do that for you. So if you want the mohair be the star player. Let me see what I done here. Yeah. If you have, for example, this yarn and you want it to be like this, but then with a mohair feel, then you use those two colors together and you will have this piece. And if you want it lighter, then use the mohair on a tonal. If you use a dark tonal, and you want your shiny mohair be the star player, just put them together. Sorry, I was confused. And then you get this. And you see that the mohair is doing its job. It's not a tonal anymore. It was color sangria, actually. This color, I don't have it now with me. It is a pity. This color with this mohair will give you your tonal, but your star player in this is mohair. And these two together, same mohair, same merino, that will give the actually color of merino with the mohair together. So mohairs in variegated yarns, in variegated colors, they will come best out when you use a darker tonal underneath. So if you have a very nice, like this color, and you say, oh, I put white mohair together with it, it will soften this tone a lot. So keep that in mind when you choose mohair. But if you want variegated mohair, and you want that to be the star player, use a darker tonal. If you want it exactly the same, use the same tonal. Now, and what does mohair in finished projects? I showed you this already. This is a double thread mohair and it's light as a feather. One color. And it's a big surface, so alternate skeins, please. Here we have Birdie, and that's a very bright pink, with Birdie Suri Alpaca. And on the baby Suri Alpaca, the pink doesn't get it so much. So the baby Suri Alpaca in the same color is lighter. And this is what you get. Here, I had a variegated yarn underneath and a white mohair. And the variegated yarn was very bright and speckly, but they were all toned down by the mohair. So this is merino and mohair together. On a smaller needle size, I think 3.5, because on this project was a variegated yarn and a white mohair on a bigger needle size. This is the ranunculus. And here you can still see the speckles. Mohair's playing with it. And last, oh no, second last. This is the birds of a feather shawl, and here you see the mohair used on its own, the same color as the merino four-ply, and it makes the shawl so light and wearable. So I have lots of kits for the birds of a feather in my shop, and again, if you see other colors, just let me know and I make it a kit as well. And here, and I showed you that last time, but here you see the baby alpaca. It's kind of, because it's thicker than mohair, it's kind of laying on top of the merino. And it's knitted the yoke with a double thread. And it gives you that velvet look. Okay, so choose mohair. And if you need advice, you can always ask me to advise you as well. Okay, some things from the shop, not much anymore. I have not much yarn to show. They're all in my shop, and my shop now has a compare box. So if you like colors, but you're not sure how they look together, and you get the, first you get all the blues, then the greens, then the pinks, and the yellows, just click on compare, and then if you go to your compare box, you see them all together. I think there's a max of four. Yeah, so yeah, head to my web shop. I have lots of kits with, at the kit you get the pattern through Ravelry by me. And if you're Dutch and you need a Dutch translation for those kits, I will make an additional copy in your order next to the Ravelry original, of course, because I'm not doing the designers wrong. You get the pattern through Ravelry, not just a copy. Two more mini sets in the shop. a set of 12, this is. And there is a set of 24 plus one mohair skein, and that's in the advent calendars. I already sold 3 rounds, so I'm already preparing, and I made a few extra, and those extra are probably for you, because I have 1 pinks and co and 3 blues and co's left. So if you want an advent calendar, just go to the webshop and read all about it. So I think that's it for now. I'm done talking, and I really hope you liked it. And like last time, please give it a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe, that's very nice for me as well. Leave comments, I will get to you. And everything that I spoke of will be in the links below. And if you need anything, just email me. I'm so happy to help you. Bye, have a very nice day. Bye-bye.